Before we start the tutorial, I just want to let you know, if you're having trouble understanding what I say, open the subtitles under the video, I wrote them just for you. Good luck! Today I will teach you how to convert your MMD model for V-tubing. First of all, make sure that your model is a humanoid, else this tutorial won't work for non-humanoid models. Make sure your model morphs are all prepared, separate from your MMD model that you use for motions. You don't need anything else, just the names of everything in English, as it will be easier to use. Our links will be in the description. First of all, you need to download UniVRM, specifically VRM 0.x. This is important as some programs such as Warudo, for example, at this time, doesn't support 0.1. You will also need this. You go to the site and scroll down to MMD for Mechanic Beta. Click over here for the download. I already have it downloaded. Once you're done downloading, make sure to open Unity. I use Unity 2021.3. Create a new project. Name it whatever you want. Make sure that it's in 3D. Save it where it's more convenient for you specifically. For me, it's on my desktop. Click Create once you're done. Wait for it to load. Once it's ready, it should look like this. Now all you need to do is drag this UniVRM into the assets. Wait for it to load and then click Import. Once it's ready, it should pop up like this. You don't care about anything here, you just need to click Import. Now that it's loaded, go to MMD Form Mechanism and extract it to where you like it to be. Open it and then choose this, MMD Form Mechanism. Drag it to the assets once again. Wait for it to load, for the window to pop up, and then click Import. Here this window popped up. Now you could just click Import. If this window pops up, just click Yes. Once it's all done, you can create a folder for your model. Drag your MMD model into the tutorial folder or whatever folder you made. Now you will see this. Please make sure that you have the permission of the creators of the model you're using. If it's for personal use, still make sure that they allow to import it. Click on Agree and boom, proceed. This will convert all your model. Wait for it to finish. Once it's all done, it should look more or less like this. Click on your model. That for some reason doesn't load for me. And click on it, go to Rig and select Humanoid. This will make sure that your model will have the basic humanoid rig for it to read it. Click on Head and make sure that there are no extra bones in places they shouldn't be, like hair on the jawbone. Make sure that all the bones are correct. Once you're done, you scroll down and click Apply. Wait for it to load, then click Done. Now you can drag your model into the scene. As you see, here is the model. Click on Materials folder and click on all the materials in there. Make sure to go to VRM and MTune. Choose the shadows, which one do you prefer more. I like it to be dark blue. Make sure that expressions are transparent, otherwise they won't work exactly like how you expect them to work in MMD. Now that's all done, you can click on your model and click on this new window, VRM0. Click on Export to VRM0. Once you're done, you click on export. Save the model where it's more convenient for you, because we're not done yet. Now that it's done, you can get rid of the model. Now you create the newly created VRM folder, drag it into assets again. To add new expressions or edit them, go to your model name blend shapes. Here you will have the basic blend shapes. To edit them, simply click on them to select them and click on here. UCHAR-1. Make sure to scroll to the expression that you like. You will have this little window down here to show you the expression look. To add more blend shapes, you click on this blend shape. Create blend shape clip. Now you just create a new one. Name it whatever you like. Now you just click on it and select whatever you want it to do. As you can see in the preview, your mouth will change shape into a cat. This is a fairly poor example as its body changes, so I will show it with an A. As you can see, your mouth opens. You make sure that it's at 100 so that it will open properly. Now that you're done with your blend shapes, make sure that they are working. Now you go to back to your folder and drag the model into the scene. Now to add jiggle physics, you need to find first the bones you wanna do it for. You won't have this. Now that you found the bone that you would like to add jiggle physics to, select spring bone, and that should be it to add jiggle physics. Make sure to go to root bones and add one. Drag your bone that you like to jiggle into here. Now if you click play and move to the scene, if I move the model, the tail should wag. As you can see, now it's wagging. To add colliders, it's really simple. You go to where you like to add it. Go on VRM and find Springbone Collider Group. This will be the collider that doesn't allow your tail, for example, to collide with this part. To make sure that it works, you go into here, collider group, and add one. So click on this tiny circle, and then click the collider you have. Now the tail won't touch this area. Now as you can see, the tail doesn't want to touch that area. It will show you when you select the model. Tail will collide with everything but this pink circle. Now that you're done with jiggle physics and colliders, you can go to VRM0, export VRM model. Oops, excuse me. You select this model itself, the whole thing. Click on VRM, export VRM. Please ignore this. I just removed them. Export and save it where you like it to be. Wait for it to load and you're basically done. Now if you load up Barudo or any other program you're using and upload your model into it, it should be working. Once Barudo finally loads, you can click on get started to open the folder where your models are. Click on folder. Open char character folder and drag your done model into here. For me, it's a tutorial RAM. Drag it in here and it should appear on Barudo. Wait for it to load the model. click OK. Let it recommend settings for you. This is not a very good tutorial, so I won't comment much on what I'm doing. I'm sorry. Wait for it to load again. And as you can see, here is a model. And now this is done. As you can see, it's tracking my mouth. Not very good, but it's tracking it. And that was a tutorial on how to convert your MMD model into Varudo. If you have any questions, I will leave a Discord server invite where you can contact me in person and ask for any help you need. Make one thing though, I'm not a professional at this, so if you have a non-humanoid model, I won't be able to help. Thank you all for watching. Goodbye.